welcome to Saffron Trail Kitchen. As a kid, I never liked beets, but once when my aunt made beetroot halwa, I really fell in love with it. So that's the recipe I've taken from my aunt to share with you this Diwali. Follow me to my kitchen and let's see how to make it. So I've kept a pressure pan on heat. We got to add roughly 2 spoons of ghee to this. 2 teaspoons, so yeah, a little more. And to this we'll add the grated beets. I'm just going to saute the beets in the ghee for like 2 to 3 minutes. If you don't have a pressure pan, you can do this in a heavy bottom pan with a lid, but it will take a much longer time to do it in a pan. In this, it gets cooked really fast. After sauteing the grated beets for around 2 to 3 minutes, I'm going to add roughly 3/4 cup of milk to this. So I've added some milk. This is just to help it to pressure cook the beet in the pressure pan. Give it a slight mix. Now I'll put on the lid of the pressure cooker with the whistle. And we'll give this around 2 whistles, switch off, allow it to cool, and then open, and then proceed with the recipe. So after 2 to 3 whistles, we'll just check if the pressure cooker is cooled enough to open, and it is. So we'll just open and check. So you'll see that the beet has cooked well, and we'll start the flame again for the gas. So at this point we'll add sugar. For 1/2 kilo of beets, roughly 3/4 cup of sugar. Again, you need to taste and see how it works, because every variety of beetroot is slightly different. So I can't give you an exact measurement, but roughly it's around this much. So at the same time, this is khoya ready made, so we'll just add the crumbled khoya into this. If it's a bit hard, you can grate it as well. This is quite soft, so I'm just crumbling the whole thing. So I'm using around 100 grams of crumbled khoya. So the sugar has melted, and you'll see that there's more liquid in the pan, and I've managed to mash the crumbled khoya with the back of the spatula. So we'll just have to allow this to simmer for like 3-4 minutes until it's somewhat dried out, and then we'll prepare the garnish for the halwa. So I've been stirring this for the last 5 to 7 minutes. And you can see that the khoya is completely mixed up into the halwa. If you don't find khoya, you can also use thickened milk, like after boiling milk for some time, and then add it to the halwa, or you can use milk powder instead. You'll see now that the beetroot has dried up. So I'm going to put this behind and keep another pan for the garnish, which is some ghee. Not too much, just about 1 teaspoon or so. So compared to most other festival and Diwali sweets, this is still, I'd say, a little less on the ghee and the sugar. So we'll wait for the ghee to melt. And then I have some cashews here. If you like, you can add raisins, or you can even top it with sliced pistas. this is almost done. In the heat of the ghee itself, it will turn more golden. So I'm going to keep it aside. And we'll remove our beetroot halwa into a bowl. So vibrant and red in color. And now for the final garnish. So there you go, our Diwali special beetroot halwa is ready. The same beetroot halwa recipe you can make either with pumpkin or with bottle gourd. I do hope you try it out this Diwali. If you like this recipe, do give me a thumbs up, share it with your friends. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And do subscribe to Saffron Trail. I wish you and your family a very happy Diwali.